So today this little in-service is about an alternative to the use of restrictive practices in the care of older people. So onto the background, unfortunately older people in a confused state are often restrained before all least restrictive options are exhausted. Previously, physical restraints have involved things like arm holds, wrist and ankle straps, closed doors, locked gates, etc. Research has shown that these practices are associated with poor outcomes, such as loss of function and increased confusion. When laws around physical restraint became a bit tighter, there was a shift to chemical restraint, both PRN and regular medication. This turned out to be equally as damaging to elderly people, as they're more susceptible to over-medication and the negative reactions from polypharmacy. Moving on to legislation, there were over 14 documents that were relevant to Australia. So these are three that were relevant to New South Wales as well. So we got the Australian Law Reform Commission of 2014, which states that many restrictive practices may infringe a person's human rights. We got New South Wales Health's 2020 Policy Directive on Seclusion and Restraint in New South Wales Health Settings. And it states that all services must have systems that minimise and, where possible, eliminate the use of seclusion and restraint. And then with regards to the Aged Care Quality and Safety Commission, Part 4A of the Quality of Care Principles states that restraint must always be used as a last resort. So we'll now move on to the actual innovation. So if you think about it, we use audiovisual stimulation to distract or calm our children or toddlers down, which normally works better than yelling at them or locking them in their room. So I'm thinking we should take the same approach with older people suffering from dementia or acute confusion. Healthcare and aged care facilities could implement this strategy by having designated iPads or other electronic devices that can be used when patients need stimulation or distraction. Studies have shown that sensory stimulation is vital to emotional well-being overall, so it's absolutely necessary in aged care settings. It may actually be boredom that's distressing them more so than usual. So in that case, the person can be stimulated by the iPad with interactive videos and music. Choose something that's relevant to their culture and lifestyle. For example, if the resident was a seasoned fisherman in his day, put on a short documentary about fishing. That way, they can relate and genuinely divert their attention towards it. In the same way, the iPad can be used as a calming technique if they're overstimulated. So you could take the person to a quiet room and play meditative videos and a tranquil video of nature, something like that. Again, you should make your choice relevant to their culture and lifestyle. So for example, if the elderly person was Greek, you could put on a relaxing Greek song or some soothing bouzouki music, perhaps. By enhancing the sensory elements of elderly people, you can improve their emotional well-being overall and potentially de-escalate agitation before the use of restraint is required. So my main argument here is to think about how you would de-escalate your distressed child or family member and try implement these strategies towards the person you're looking after. This is a more person-centred approach, and providing person-centred practice in line with legislation is really our main goal. Thank you.